Hi, my name is Stephen. I'm a program manager on the Project Operations R&D team. Welcome to my session on time entry capabilities inside of Project Operations. We'll be going through some lightweight scenarios, show a little bit of extensibility, touch on mobile, and talk a little bit about the future. And I look forward to taking you through it. The time entry process. Who records time? Within Project Operations, time is recorded by any bookable resource. And that time flows through our system and drives the cost and sales price figures through that ultimately result in an invoice being created. Within Project Operations, we also support the ability to record non-financial time. We do so only for the scenario of blocking out the resources availability for future time. This way, resource managers understand who is available and are able to book resources correctly for future work, while project managers understand what progress has been made against projects and tasks and are able to track financial impact on the project. The stages of the submission go from draft through to approved. However, there are scenarios where when you submit time, you may have made a mistake. Project Operations allows for a recall of a time entry in two stages. You are able to recall a time entry immediately on submission if the approver has not approved it. And you are also allowed to recall a time entry that has been approved. But the result there isn't so much that the approval happens immediately. The approval request gets created and sent through to the approver, who then has the opportunity to review the changes you're making, understand the financial impact, and allow for the transaction to continue or be rejected. Time entry as a whole is very customizable. And what we target in time entry is the ability for you in your organization to cover all the scenarios you need when recording time. Out of the box, we target projects and tasks. However, the time entry is extendable, where you may want to add your own scenarios. We often see this. Things like being able to record time on somebody else's behalf, or adding start time and end time fields, adding location for tax purposes if work is performed in a different state and you're required to do so. Or if you want to pre-populate time entries from another system, or if you have a need to pre-populate time entries from assignments or bookings. Our tooling does allow for these imports. However, different scenarios and different business requirements are the key objective of the time entry capabilities of Project Operations. We think of this in three ways. We have our weekly hours control, which is targeting common scenarios, such as a header field and hourly entry over a week. We have a canvas scenario where these are more vertical scenarios where your scenario is not catered for by our hourly week control. Perhaps you want to enter time at a week level. Perhaps you want to add additional data around the time. And then we have API access as well for bespoke scenarios. We have external systems. These are the areas of extensibility within time and the focus area of what we're building when we build features for time. Let's jump into a demo now where we will demonstrate some of these extensibility capabilities in time entry. We'll also demonstrate some of the surface areas that are available for you for customization. And we will look at the future roadmap for Project Operations in this space. So welcome to Project Operations. On the left-hand side is our primary navigation, and you'll see time entries, expense, and approvals. Let's jump into time entries. This is the standard time entry control for Project Operations. Project Operations renders the backing data in a horizontal fashion, with time entries on the right-hand side depicted as a week, and related header record on the left-hand side showing the details of that time entry. So we'll go through the process of quickly creating a time entry. I'll show you some of the functionality that time entry has, and then I'm going to take you into the extensibility opportunities you have, how to add columns to this, how to modify some of the behaviors, and I also show some of the other surface areas we have for time entry, and you have the opportunity there to make customizations too. So in this case, I've already created two time entries. You'll see that they're for Project Orange. The project task was design, and I had the role of project manager, and one has been approved and one is in draft status. I'm going to now go and add another time entry for this week. Select a project. Let's find a project task on that. Implementation. Let's specify the duration of that time entry and the date. So here we see the total for today is 8 hours. There is my 4 hour time entry. But hey, hang on, maybe perhaps I wanted to record time throughout the week. Well, that's great because we support inline time entry. And so you're able to go and recapture time for that week, and we'll go and create the related records. What you'll notice as well is that time entry is in an hour decimal format. This is done by design. So if we record time, for example, 1.5 hours, the reasoning behind that is that when we cost or price, it is typically performed in an hourly rate. And what we'd want to do is have the user think about their hourly rate and what that number entails when they're thinking about financials. But often users don't understand how to translate some of the time aspects to an hour fraction model. So we support the ability to enter time in hour and minutes and do the automatic conversion for you into that fraction. So the time entry control itself, what it's doing behind the scenes is each of these records on the right-hand side here is an individual time entry record logged for that day with each of these details associated to it. This control itself is effectively creating a pivot on that data and associating all related records and producing a single line and showing you that spread across the week. However, behind the scenes, the data is individual records for each of those time entries. It's an important concept to understand, and users don't necessarily need to grasp it. But when you come to customization, it's important to understand because it includes of how and what you would customize. So in our case here, for example, on Thursday the 18th, for Project Orange Design, I want to go and add an external comment. So I'm able to come here, hit Edit Entry, and that particular entry that I've selected, I can come in here and say External Comment, and we could say Close Out Design, Save and Close. And you'll notice that we put a little year tab here to say there's something a little different about this one in relation to the other time entries that you probably want to know about, but that is not depicted in the header record on the left. This header record on the left is virtualized. It is not a record per se. It is not stored in the database. It is derived from the fact that each of these records have the same value. So when you make changes to a single value that is at the header record level, it would result in a new line. So that's just important to understand from an extensibility perspective. Some of the other quick features before we move into the next part of the demo, our ability to import time. For those of you that haven't seen this before, we can bring in resource assignments, resource bookings, exchange appointments, all different mechanisms we have to populate your timesheet very efficiently. We're also able to copy the week from a previous week or copy rows. I can select a particular row and say copy that row and duplicate it down for me. And as such, go through and populate and complete the time. If I want to submit a time entry, and these time entries on the right-hand side, as I mentioned, are individual records, I'm able to select an individual record and say submit. And notice what happens. I mentioned that this is a virtualized view on the left-hand side. And so the system is going to go off, create the underlying records, reduce the roll down, and you'll see that it popped out this line because this value has changed. And so essentially it's duplicated everything else, but this particular entry has submitted. We did not submit those. Don't be concerned. This is not typically how users submit time. Typically how users submit time would be select all, hit submit, and all records get submitted. Regardless of if they've been approved or not, we will find all the ones that are ready to be submitted and submitted. And likewise, if you want to submit a particular project's time, you're able to select that row, hit submit, and we will submit the time for that row. All right, so that's a little bit about the control, but let's go and have a look at some of the customization capabilities now. So when I created a time entry, you saw I had a standard unified client form. This form is fully customizable. You're able to go and add any other fields you like to this, any other entities, any other data that you would like to populate, option sets, and the like. The out-of-box experience, as I'd mentioned, was the project and project task and role, but maybe perhaps I want to figure out how to log time on somebody else's behalf. So I'm going to take you through quickly how to make that modification and how that modification gets displayed in this time entry control. All right, so let's jump through to our editor experience for modifications. I'm going to perform this change as a simple customization through a customize the system, but this is not typically how you would perform this. You would traditionally go through, create a solution, pull together all the changes you want to make, as typically the change you're going to make isn't so much on a particular form like I'm about to show you now, but part of a greater solution that you're trying to implement across the system. My goal with this demo really is just to show you how to record time on somebody else's behalf, as it's a common ask, but also for those of you that haven't seen the Power Platform and its capabilities, you'll have an opportunity to see a little bit about our editor experience and understand a little bit more about what's going on behind the scenes. So here we have a list of entities. These are all the tables behind in the Dataverse. And underneath here, Project Operations has an entity referred to as Time Entry. Time Entry itself will have some metadata that associated to it that instructs the system as to what is Time Entry, how it behaves, how it should be displayed, any other fields or dashboards that are related to it. And as I mentioned, we had a form. That form is what we wanted to go and add a field to, and in this case, what we want to go and do is show how we can record time on somebody else's behalf. So I'm going to grab this form for time entry and make that modification. The create time entry form is the form that gets displayed when the user hits add time, and you'll see here that we have an editor experience that pulls through, and you will see the same fields that we saw there, which was the type of work, the duration, date, there's the project task, role, description, external comments, and the likes. So in our case, what we're trying to do is record time on another user's behalf. Within project operations, all users or all resources are referred to as bookable resources. Bookable resources is a construct for resource management that allows for us to plan based on a calendar, their availability, and also unify the concept across equipment, human resources, or any other resource type that you come up with. We have another session on our unified resource scheduling capabilities that will be held by Russell Hercules, a peer of mine, who will deep dive into the capabilities of our bookings and scheduling. But in this case, I'm going to just pull through that bookable resource, and in my system, those resources are already created. And in your system, as part of resource management, there would be two. So it's simply enough. We're going to drag it over, drop it in, and you'll see bookable resource. We can put it underneath the role. Maybe we like it there rather, or maybe not. Don't know. There we go. I'm going to hit save and close. I've made a modification to the form. This is now going to be applied to the system. I'm also going to make a modification to the grid. So the grid that is displayed to you that shows the header records on the left and the time entries on the right, we're going to modify that view to include the bookable resource so that at a header level, we understand what are those time entries that we're seeing. So now we come through to the view where we modify the My Weekly Time Entries view. This view is the default view that's used to display time entries. In this case, I'm simply going to go and add the bookable resource that we just added to the form, to the view, and we need to make a decision about how we're going to filter this. Do we want to show all bookable resources? And in my case, for this example, I'm going to simplify it by editing the filter criteria and removing the fact that we're filtering on the user being the current user. This way, we'll see all bookable resources and all entries that we have created. All right. Now we're going to publish the changes and then flip back to our time entry grid control and see the changes being displayed. Our time entry grid now includes the bookable resource. And in this case, this is my account. I'm the admin at Microsoft. I kind of think that's powerful. And I'm going to show the change in action where we've modified the quick create form to include the bookable resource that we want to log time for. So let's pick a project. Let's find the task. and pick a resource that we're going to log time against. So I'm just going to grab Frankie here, save and close. And what we now see is that the bookable resource is Frankie's. And so time submitted here would be reflected against Frankie as opposed to myself. That concludes the example of how to add a bookable resource. Let's take a look at the changes we've made on the Power Apps app, our mobile experience for project operations. Here we have project operations on the mobile. You'll see this is a reactive app where the entire site has been adjusted to fit your mobile form factor. We have all the same functionality, including time entry. Time entry, however, is rendered differently in a slightly more mobile-friendly fashion, but certainly not optimized. And this is an area of investment and feedback we're looking for. We want to improve this experience to optimize it in the same way that we have with our time entry control on the web. I did want to demonstrate this, that the changes we've made, of course, would flow through here because the underlying infrastructure is the same. So here we see the same change around the bookable resource and the ability to search and add that full time entry. So what are our plans for the future? We're really targeting that mobile experience. We want to build a delightful mobile experience that caters for your scenarios. And this is your opportunity to provide feedback. So open the QR code below through your phone or over your browser and complete the form and give us your input as to the direction you want us to take this product. And thank you for your time. If you have any questions or suggestions, we have included an ideas link. This is monitored actively by our team, and we certainly love to hear from you. Thank you very much.